I thank you.
Ngendo, but some people know me as Princess Becky Juuko of the Ebonies. I am an actress and I just want to talk about my new pictures that leaked. First of all, I am so sorry for everything. Yes, the person was me, but I did not publish those pics. I was betrayed by my ex-lover and he published them. I want to apologize to the nation, my culture, my religion, fellow women, the parents, the people that look up to me, everybody I inspire. I'm so sorry for everything. I didn't intend, I'm a victim. I want to apologize to the press and I want to thank the police, the Uganda police and the pornography committee for giving me a hearing, because these guys are parents. They listened to me and realized it was not my fault in the first place. I was just betrayed. And I want to advise all my fellow girls out there, if you guys have a problem, please just report this to the police. Because had I done this in the first place, I wouldn't be here. I was blackmailed, but I kept quiet. So if somebody out there is going through this, please report it before it's too late. These are good people and their parents. They understand. Lastly, I apologize to my boss, my workmates, the Ebonies at large. This will never happen again. I'm so sorry and I really regret, because right now I'm suffering mentally, physically. It's like I'm even traumatized. For the first time, I'm really scared of looking in the camera. It is really too much. I really can't take this. I'm so sorry to everybody.
Yeah, so thank you very much. As the Pornography Control Committee, when we got this nude pictures, we don't actually get the pictures directly. It is the public, the whistleblowers, the parents, and religious leaders, all concerned people. Ugandans always call us first and say, have you seen this? What are you going to do about it? Of course, there is a law, the Anti-Pornography Act of 2014. We could charge the person who is in the pornographic pictures and the one who published them and the ones who are distributing them. We have the power to have these people arrested and brought before the law. But the most important thing also is, first of all, to reach the person to know whether they are a victim or whether they actually published the pictures on purpose. We reached out to this girl, but police was quick, actually. They brought her to the station. And what the public, the biggest section of the public was expected that we'll put her in, that she'll be arrested and then we'll take her to court and she'll be charged. And in case she was found guilty, she'd be in for 10 years, plus or with or without the fine of 10 million, which is what this goes for. But as human beings, we called the girl, and after speaking to her, we realized that she was a victim of circumstances. She has come out and given us more information. And when someone gives us information like that, then they turn witness. They turn witness, and then we look for the people who actually publish these things on purpose, which is what we are going to do. We know, now let me bring this out right here and right now, we know that there are people who call themselves bloggers out there, whose work is to get money from the people who want to leak nudes. It has reached a level of, if I want to punish a woman, I'll look for a blogger and I will just give the nudes out there. But as a woman, I condemn this. And as a woman, I will make sure that we look for those bloggers and bring them to book. The way we did for Kato Ashberg, the way we have done for someone who is in right now, called Innocent. Those who take pictures either to extort money or to embarrass a woman, some of them are even lovers who have been rejected. So you reject someone and the next thing they do is to have your pictures published like that. Not reject them, but maybe you chuck them, or you want to get out of that relationship. And someone says, I would blackmail you with what I have. This is what we are getting all over. And I am giving you a promise that we're going to look for these people and bring them to book. Not this girl. Because this girl has said all she had to say and we have verified her information. And the information is as she has given it to us. She's going to speak for herself. But what I'm saying that men out there who are hoping to blackmail women with nudes, you'll be brought to book. The ones who they use, called bloggers, you'll be brought to book after publishing these images. I will repeat that we are working with police very well. We are working with Uganda Communications Commission very well. And these are able to take us, to help us with their digital loggers to go backwards and see who actually published the image first. And those are the people we are looking for. So this girl will receive help from us. But at the same time, if there is any girl who is out there who is being threatened because someone has their nudes, let them come out, reach out to us. We'll be of help rather than leaving you in the hands of extortionists who keep asking for money and blackmail.